They've got some advantages and they've got some major disadvantages. I would say the biggest advantage they have is they still have the opportunity for rapid growth, even though it's going to be much slower, because they have at least another 100,000 people in poverty, which is a disadvantage, but there's an awful lot of opportunity for continued growth, albeit much less than the growth has been in the past. But I think the United States has far more advantages, and I think the problems we have pale in comparison to those that China has. And I think that there's actually more danger, or at least as much danger, in exaggerating China's strength as there is in underestimating their potential.
But so many Americans look at the rise of China recently, and they look at the education capacity, they look at the benefits that a control economy can have in terms of dictating stimulus and how the economy runs, and they think, wow, we're never going to be able to compete.
Yeah, they think, some people say, well, they've developed a better form of capitalism. And I say, not true. There's a naive view of certain Americans that it's an authoritarian government, so they can just place an order. But frankly, his political problems are very significant, and he's trying to transform this whole country. Major reforms, and the most difficult ones, there isn't a consensus. And it's going to take a good while, and he's going to have to work very hard and consolidate more power to get it done. So it's one thing to talk about, you know, rebooting a $10 trillion economy. It's another thing to do it. But he's not only trying to do that, but clean up a dirty environment, to change the whole relationship between the central government and provincial and municipal governments, modernize the institutions at the central government level, and to do all that through a party which is rife with corruption and without the legal system or the laws you can count on.
You were Treasury Secretary, of course, during the financial crash, and it was at that point that people started asking questions about the capitalist model, the Western capitalist model, and I imagine they were asking those questions in China, too. How did the crash look from Beijing?
We know how harmful the crisis was to America, but in terms of America's standing in the world, I remember just like it was yesterday, in June of 2008, when Wang Qishang, who was the vice premier and my counterpart, arrived for our SED meetings, Strategic Economic Dialogue meetings in Washington, D.C. And I'd been pressing him to open up their capital markets. And he said to me, Hank, we're going to have difficulty doing that. You were our teacher, and our teacher doesn't look so smart anymore. And so, again, I could say everything I wanted to say about how we were moving to clean it up, and they could learn from our mistakes, and et cetera. And I knew he believed that reform was the right thing. But a healthy, strong, dynamic economy is a prerequisite to global leadership.